So hello everyone and welcome back to some more Portal 2 here with GLaDOS and Wheatley with his strange plans, and let's go and head to the next chambers and see whatever he's been up to, considering he was supposed to have a surprise for us and everything too and all that jazz. So good question, whatever there might be ahead of here. And
I'll bet you're both dying to know what your big surprise is. Well, only two more chambers.
We're running out of time. I think I can break us out of here in the next chamber. Just play along.
It's kind of silly, like, he says only two more chambers, and didn't we have basically like two more chambers of GLaDOS and stuff before Wheatley broke us out? So, but yeah, any help from you, GLaDOS, would be, of course, good and helpful. And, alright. Great. 17 out of 19, indeed. And, I may not be the most awake right now, so hopefully I can still manage to solve puzzles well enough. Well, that seems extremely simple nonetheless, of just catching it while it is flying and all that.
Surprise! We're doing it now.
Oh. That was interesting, yeah.
Ah. Built specifically for testing.
Oh.
Oh no. He found the cooperative testing initiative. It's something I came up with to phase out human testing just before you escaped. It wasn't anything personal, just, you know, you did kill me. Fair's fair.
Fair's fair.
Well, this is the part where he kills us.
Hello.
He will attempt to
kill you.
Yeah.
Brainwave. There I was, smashing some steel plates together. And I thought to myself, yeah, it's deadly. But what's missing? What's missing? And I thought, lots of sharp bits welded onto the flat bits. It's still a work in progress, don't judge me yet. But, you know, eventually, I'd like to get them to sort of shoot fire at you moments before crushing you. That's what I'm aiming for. But, you know, small steps.
Very small steps.
And don't bother trying to portal out of here, because it's impossible. Okay, I've thought of everything. What?
Conversion gel.
Yeah, true.
No, I don't think it is. No. Don't do that. Stand right here. Stop. Where'd you go? Come back.
That's funny. Just trying to smash me afterwards. But probably it's meant so that you can easily enough escape. But yeah, that conversion gel indeed.
Do come back, please. Come back, please.
No, thanks, Wheatley. No, thank you.
Okay, look, I've decided I'm not gonna kill you, okay, if you come back.
No. You can try to kill me all you want.
Oh, just thinking back to the old times, the old days when we were friends, good old friends, not enemies. And I would say something like, come back, and you'd be like, yeah, no problem, and you'd come back. What happened to those days?
What happened is the fact that you became my enemy. You wanted to start killing me. You became crazy by being in control of everything. So that's about what happened. You weren't yourself anymore. I can put a portal in there. Should I? Do I need to? Like, I could put portal there too, but is there any sense in that? Well, yeah, if I want to launch into there, I think that would seem like a reasonable choice. Let's go.
Can't help but notice that you're not coming back, which is disappointing.
Well.
Oh, I've got an idea. Yes, in your face, I got armor.
Fine, let the games begin.
Let the games begin indeed, yes. That sounds good to me. What, two red box though? I wonder. There's a gel flow in there too, yeah? Was there somewhere in here yet? Here's a better spot for me to portal from. Yes, there is. But sure, let's let the games begin. You can try to kill me all you wish. We're done with puzzle rooms. Should be even more fun for you, right? I would assume. Good music.
I'm almost there. Don't mind me. Continue escaping.
Let's see, what should we do here?
Okay, yes, it's a trap, but it's the only way through. Let's just do it.
Yeah, only way to go is going into the trap, which is a great idea. Nope, not very efficiently killing, no sirree.
Silently killing you, probably. Might have to guess. perhaps the turrets have found a way to use garrots. That would explain the extremely quiet killing that I'm hearing.
You remember we sabotaged them, right?
Stomp once. If you're dead, just obviously no stomps. And two stomps if you're not dead. Alright, so let me just run through it again. If you're dying but not dead, stomp just once. If you're dead, obviously you won't be stomping. And if you're not dead, give me a couple of stomps, two stomps. You know, I would tell you.
No, talking!
Alright, that is common courtesy. Mark of a civil society. So just let me know.
What if I don't want to let you know?
That's probably long enough. Are you dead yet? How about now?
He's so impatient. So very, very impatient. Interesting picture, by the way, having that turret there and the kids looking at it. And then in the night, like, what would it in the children's room anyway? But it looks like that's one way that they were selling it, which is very intriguing indeed. Poor turrets being all messed up. Like, this is even wrong way, like I was looking before. Extra dead.
Ha! Was that your bullet riddled body flying out of the room? It went, oh, those were the crap turrets, weren't they?
Yeah.
Well, no matter, because I'm still holding all the cards. And guess what? They're all full houses. Never actually played cards, meaning to learn. Anyway, new turrets, not defective. Ace of Fours, the best hand. Unbeatable, I would imagine.
Right. I'm sure. I believe in you, Wheatley. There is some turrets flying on top there, and those do seem to, and there has been some active turrets, I can't deny that, so most likely these are active.
Activated.
Yes, sirs, they are. However, can always do some trickies with them. Getting rid of a couple of the very least, and then just need to figure out what spot this guy is. Ouch indeed. Poor turrets. Critical error, and then I'm gonna even drop you out completely. Be happy. What about in this way? What's in here? This doesn't look promising in the least, although... Yeah, I was just thinking that maybe there is a spot to portal, maybe there's a secret in there, even though I highly doubted that it would be the right way to go, but it could always have some secrets. It could be possibility at the very least. This does definitely require one of these though, if possible. But what spot would it be possible from if we would be trying to go into there? Yeah, can't do anything into there. Alright, is there any conversion shell anywhere, or... is that the only place where I can see where I could be doing portals? That is actually close, like in this spot, yeah. That will work.
I see. Clever. Very clever. And fool. Well, good, good. Finally, a nemesis worthy of my vast intellect.
Or your stupidity. That was the thing, that you were a moron. But sure, it wasn't the worst idea in the world. Sadly, like, there was some sort of a cut at the very least when I was going into that, but... regardless. Interesting overall.
Holmes versus Moriarty. Aristotle versus Mashie's fight place. Stay still, please.
I don't wanna. I didn't really wanna go that way anymore, you know?
Where'd you go? Where'd you go? Come back, come back!
I don't know. Where might I be? I'm hiding from you for sure, Wiz. Now there's a lot of bouncy gel.
That's... did something break back there?
Yeah.
Oh, did it kill you? That would be amazing if it killed you.
Not quite.
Yes, alright, no, just had a brainwave. I'll be back. If you're still alive, I'm gonna be back. Don't die until I get back.
Why didn't you? Wouldn't you like me to die while you're not here? Is my question. That's a turret line and a half. Interesting. I don't think though that, like, I can get into a good enough position in there from here. I think that it would be quite risky. Well, I guess I could try to, but it would be kind of risky to try to get into this spot. I'd have to say, when it's not completely right on top there even. And I don't know where I would be going afterwards. Like, I would want to get there, I'd say, but I can't be putting portals through the glass. Well, I did make it into here, so that's something. Is there a chance for me to then put a portal all the way over there? From here. And I guess that's a no. I'm not sure that that's something I can do though. But then there has to be something I need to be able to do in there. Because otherwise, yeah, that would be completely pointless. What happens sometimes, you sometimes have to die.
Something break back there. Oh, did it kill you?
No.
That would be amazing if it killed you.
Why would it be so amazing, though?
Yes, alright, no, just had a brainwave. I'll be back. If you're still alive, I'm gonna be back. Don't die until I get back.
Ooh, there's actually a spot where I can go. Alright, that seems better. Uh-huh, interesting. Interesting indeed. What does this do? It gives more of this. This works way better. Way better, as long as I just hit them. Whee! And just a couple of more turrets to hit. There goes one more. Then just those two left. I was thinking that that's maybe is a little bit too far. But that's good. That's perfect. There we go. That is also interesting to get some more into there if I wanted to for some reason. Yeah, there I can't do anything. Which is totally fine, I guess. That's not what I wanted to do. No, don't launch with us. Why did I put the freaking blue goo right into that spot? Why? Well, I guess then I gotta do this all over again. So that I can... Actually, with the control you were supposed to be able to not have to do that, right? I think, but whatever. I'll put some bounciness in here then, just so that I can maybe bounce back into there. From here too, if I happen to fall. But yeah, I think that the control was something that you were supposed to be able to not bounce with. Yes. Exactly. Cool, cool. That's what I need to remember. It's also a thing even though I've never used it really. Well, still alive for now. Always still alive. Always. Wonder where Winley is hanging. You have a really long list of plans of how to torture and kill him, to be honest. I think that that's a little much nonetheless. I'm just saying, like, couldn't we be getting out of that sort of positioning at some point, but I guess that's just really a big part of your personality. There's more conversion gel. Waiting. But waiting on what exactly? This one. Alright. That doesn't look like the most promising situation, but it is bombs. So, I guess maybe it is. Maybe we wanna keep destroying this after all. Gotta just hope that those don't hit me and that they hit the right spot. There we go. A lot of bombs. And I got some conversion gel. No more though. It just completely got destroyed, but at least enough so that I can actually go somewhere. Like probably over there, just simply put, to be honest, because where else would I be going? In here. Interesting looking place. And this is open. I wasn't sure that it would be. Maybe I should just have a peek around overall though and not just go immediately to the first place that I see as a logical place to go, but I don't see anything else regardless. So, doesn't look like I can really interact with any of these. Then there's orange gel. All the different shells, and there's some more bombs, maybe, or whatever that's doing. That looks like a crushing trap. I just accidentally walked off, like when I was like going backwards. Then walked a little bit to the side. I didn't mean to, but it happened. I died very stupidly. Weedly got a kill, which he didn't deserve.
Ah, there you are. Great. Let's get rid of this
apple. Really getting rid of everything.
I wanted to talk to you for a moment, if I may.
Uh-huh.
To be honest, The death traps have been a bit of a failure so far for both of us.
Uh-huh.
I agree. And you are getting very close to my lair.
Yes.
Lair. It's weird that first time I said that. It sounds a bit, ridiculous, really. But I can assure you, it is one. It is a proper lair. Deadly lair. And I just wanted to give you the chance to kill yourself now.
Oh.
Before you get to the lair. You can just jump into that masher just there. Less a death trap, more a death option for you. Sounds crazy, I know, but hear me out, hear me out. Once you get to my lair, death will not be optional, alright? It will be mandatory. No tricks, no surprises, just you dying as a result of me killing you in a very, very gruesome way. So, but your offer here is just kill yourself. You know? That's a lot of effort, isn't it, walking all the way to my deadly lair?
Uh-huh.
Where there's a perfectly serviceable death option right there. Again, not a death trap, not a death
trap.
Your death would be entirely voluntary.
Uh-huh.
The masher does work, I should point out as well. I know we've had a couple of problems in the past. This masher definitely works, and it will kill you. If that's one of your concerns about not jumping in, the masher will kill you straight away, painless. Well, it won't be painless, obviously, but it will mash you up. In summary, walk all the way to certain doom or give up now, honourably, like a samurai. Save yourself a trip. It's a win-win for you.
Is it, though?
I have put a lot of effort in getting this lair ready for you, so it would certainly teach me a lesson if you simply died painlessly 20 feet from the door. I'd be furious. I'd be like, I've got my just desserts. No more than I deserve. But why not teach me a lesson? Why just jump in the old masher?
Right.
If I was up against impossible odds, this is the way I'd want to go out. Mashed with dignity.
Uh-huh.
The way I choose. And here's the best part. There's a conveyor belt that will convey you in convenient comfort right into the masher. You wouldn't have to let everything be taken care of. Didn't have to do that. Look, anyway.
Right.
Take your time. I'll let you think about it. And I don't want to pressure you. Is it the lair? Is it the masher? All right. You know what my opinion is on the masher. I'm leaning towards the masher. Up to you. Just to give you some time.
Wow, letting me actually think. That was a long talk. I do have to wonder, considering there can be achievements that there is an achievement to get smashed up, to be actually convinced into doing it. I'm kind of intrigued about it, so I guess I might just quickly check it. It's not like it's a long time to get into a checkpoint, so sure.
Oh, wow, good. I didn't think that was going to work.
I did not think that was going to work. Yeah, what a surprise. Well, at least I could hear Wheatley's funny comment about me actually doing it. So, it's not all bad, even though there was no achievement, but at least there was a funny comment about it working.
There you are! Great! Let's get rid of this.
I was like, am I accidentally now getting into there?
There we go. I wanted to talk to you for a moment, if I may. I'll be honest. The death traps have been a bit of a failure so far for both of us, I think you'll agree. And you are getting very close to my lair. Lair. Okay, I'll take that as a lair. Right, well, may the best man win. Sphere, may the best sphere win. Swap that in for much more clever books.
Oh, that's good. That's funny to get the hit his face with it first rather than actually this, which makes more sense honestly, but you know. Alrighty, so I can also cover this completely. I wonder how that would exactly work though, to be honest. Like, could one then actually run into there? Probably not, right? It seems a little bit surprising if one could, but as such, it's not like I see a lot of better options. Like, if I run into there and then just have a portal in there, that way at least I can get out. There is, of course, that area too. That might be the better area. I have no idea which area is the more logical one to get into to begin with. Well, let's see. This definitely at least does work. What a music. I am interested about that area though. Like, I have no idea which one is the one I should be at, but yep, clearly not here. Well, at least I checked. when I considered that it could be interesting to nonetheless see and know. Oops. So much easier to be on the other side, clearly enough. Alright. Most likely a lot of things. What an interesting looking construction, honestly. I wonder where that bomb is going. It's just going there, or does it then explode over there? Eventually? Question mark. It's very, very slowly traveling. I just wanna know what happens to it. It just went in there and nothing seemed to really happen. But it is going into that sort of spot where I can't exactly go. So I would need to be able to jump high enough to be able to go and start traveling with that, I'd say. But the question, I guess, is how? Right, I think we need gel in here. Ooh. So we can run up it to get to the destination. Sounds good to me. There we go. We're on the way. Wherever this goes. I think that you are waking up who you were before, because you were Caroline, you were the woman, and not just an AI your entire life. But yeah, it's understandable that you would have wanted to rebel. Like, it's absolutely normal. I like to rebel if something is trying to control me, and when they are hanging up cores and everything on you constantly to try to make you behave and sus. Like, that shouldn't have been the case to begin with, when you were supposedly, or having the Caroline personality. I think it was Caroline, right? like, almost at least that name. When you have that, then yeah, it's just... it seems pretty wrong, controlling basically an AI slash person then, with those sort of things. I think we can become, or be in an understanding, I hope. It depends if you decide to try to kill me or not. So, it's a little 50-50. It's a little 50-50, I'd say. Teeny tiny bit. Alright. And here we are. In the next area. Okay, so I should be going from there to then here? Or from here to just here, the little bit higher spot. Hey.
Of course, we're in luck. You find a way to stun him, I'll send you a core, and then you attach it to him. If we do it a few times, he might become corrupt enough for another core transfer.
Alright, sure. Sounds good to me. These are definitely a lot of corrupt cores of different kinds and different variety. And a lot of gels that we're gonna be playing with, which is going to be interesting. Interesting indeed.
Plug me in and I'll take you up.
Sure.
Look, even if you think we're still enemies, we're enemies with a common interest. Revenge. You like revenge, right? Everybody likes revenge. Well, let's go get some.
Sure, let's go get some.
Building's gonna self-destruct in about 6 minutes. I'm pretty sure it's a problem with the light. I think the light's on the blink, but just in case it isn't, I am actually gonna have to kill you, as discussed earlier. So let's call that 3 minutes and then a minute break, but we should leave allegedly 2 minutes to figure out how to shut down whatever is starting all the fires. So anyway, that's the itinerary. Also, I took the liberty of watching the tapes of you killing her, and I'm not going to make the same mistakes. Four-part plan is this. One, no portal surfaces. Two, start the neurotoxin immediately. Three, bomb-proof shields for me. Leading directly onto number four, bombs for throwing it. You know what, this plan is so good, I'm going to give you a sporting chance and turn off the neurotoxin. I'm joking, of course. Goodbye.
Neurotoxin level at capacity in 5 minutes.
All right.
Where are you going? Don't run! Don't run!
Yes. You say that there's no surfaces, right? You should be maybe throwing me a bomb over here. Thank you very much.
That sounded real. No, that was actually an impression of you.
Uh-huh.
Because you just fell into my trap, my brilliant trap.
Yes.
I wanted you to trick me into bursting that pipe. Seemingly tricked me, to give you false hope. Because that leads to overconfidence, and that leads to mistakes, fatal mistakes, and it's all part of the plan. I actually made my actual first mistake by telling you my plan just now. The old deal again.
Okay.
With that knowledge, I imagine you won't even use the conversion gel. Fate. Cruelness. That conversion gel has been sitting in that pipe going stagnant for years. You'll probably get botulism for portaling through it like that. And you'll probably get ringworm and athlete's foot and cholera or something. Horrible.
Interesting. There is also this blue gel, so let's try to see about getting this blue gel. Oh, that's great. That's what I need, I'd say. There you go. You did it. You bombed yourself. Okay. Space. There you go.
Core corruption at 50%. Vent system compromised. Neurotoxin offline. Reactor explosion in 4 minutes.
What happened? What have you bombed to me? Hold on. The bloody bombs are stuck on. Doesn't matter. I've reconfigured the shields.
Before
you bombed me. Who told you to do that? Was it her? It's just making me stronger, love. It's a fool.
Totally.
We've had some times.
You had it the wrong way. You little silly one.
Quick, what's the situation? Hey, you pretty lady. Name's Rick. So you out having yourself a little adventure. What, are you fighting that guy? You got that under control? You know, because there's a lot of stuff on fire. Hey, count that clock. Man, that is trouble. Situation pretty ugly.
Of course, that's a beautiful woman.
I don't want to scare you. I'm an adventure sphere, designed for danger. Why don't you go ahead and have yourself a little lady break, and I'll just take it from here. Here, stand behind me. Yeah, just like that. Just like you're doing.
That Maybe sounds so weird.
Going for it yourself, huh? All right, Angel. I'll do what I can to cover you.
I need to get it better.
Gotta say, the view's mighty nice from right here. Man, that clock is moving fast.
Warning.
There we go.
Corruption at 75%. Reactor explosion timer destroyed. Reactor explosion
okay, cool.
Emergency preemption protocol initiated. This facility will self-destruct in 2 minutes.
Enough! I told you not to put these cores on, but you don't listen, do you? Quietly, not listening to a word I say, judging, silent, worst kind. All I wanted to do was make everything better for me.
Okay, sure.
Solve a couple of
This one should do it.
Sure. Let's see if it can do it. Where is it? Uh-huh.
You are about to get me killed. Before the invention of scrambled eggs in 1912,
okay.
This was either whole eggs still in the shell.
So I need to run into that and then
according to most
I guess
the world's best name is Craig.
Like that.
The moon orbits the Earth every 27.32 days. Halley's comet can be viewed orbiting Earth every 76 years. For the other 75, it retreats to the heart of the sun, where it hibernates undisturbed. The first commercial airline flight took to the air in 1914. Everyone involved screamed the entire way. Marie Curie invented the theory of radioactivity, the treatment of radioactivity, and dying from radioactivity. 89% of magic tricks are not magic.
Yes, yes, yes.
Whales are twice as intelligent and three times as delicious as humans.
Warning.
We got it at least.
100%.
There.
Manual core replacement required.
Oh, I see.
Substitute core, are you ready to start?
Yes.
Core, are you ready to start?
What do you think?
Interpreting vague answer as yes.
No. Did you pick up on my sarcasm?
Stalemate detected.
Well, then I have to be...
Stalemate resolution annex. Extinguishing.
All right. Okay.
Oh, this cleans right off, does it? Well, that would have been good to know a little earlier.
Stalemate resolution associated. Please press the stalemate resolution button.
What? Where?
Do not press that button.
We're so close. Don't press the button.
No! Do not do it. I forbid you to press it.
Press it. Press the button.
Don't
yeah,
press
I
button.
Will if I know how to.
Don't press it.
Okay,
come
there.
Press the button.
No, yes, I will be pressing
press
the button.
Do not do it.
Ouch.
Are you still alive? You're joking. You have got to be kidding me. Well, I'm still in control, and I have no idea how to fix this place.
Oh, dear.
You had to
That's a moon.
Cat and mouse, didn't you? While people were trying to work.
We're going to body die. Okay. I really put us into space.
Let go! We're in space!
Space!
Ah, let go! Let go! I'm still connected! I can pull myself in! I can still fix this!
You can't.
And you are not coming back.
Oh no! Change your plans! Hold on to me! Tighter! Ah, grab me!
Well, but at least GLaDOS grabbed me though. So don't have to go into space. Just a little bit of a otherwise hurt, but GLaDOS is fixing herself up, not to have to be a potato head. That just happened. Lunacy here, yeah? Just going into moon. Can do portals there too. Well, it kind of makes sense considering how it is, like the moon dust stuff that we brought. Hey.
Oh, thank God, you're all right.
Hey.
You know. Being Carolyn taught me a valuable lesson. I thought you were my greatest enemy, when all along you were my best friend.
Aww.
The surge of emotion that shot through me when I saved your life taught me an even more valuable lesson, where Carolyn lives in my brain.
Carolyn, delete.
Goodbye, Carolyn.
Aww.
You know, deleting Carolyn just now taught me a valuable lesson. The best solution to a problem is usually the easiest one. And I'll be honest, killing you is hard. You know what my days used to be like? I just tested. Nobody murdered me, or put me in a potato, or fed me to birds. I had a pretty good life. And then you showed up. You dangerous, mute lunatic. So you know what? You win. Just go.
Okay.
It's been fun. Don't come back.
Deleted Carolyn though. That's pretty sad. Pretty sad. Pretty sad, I gotta say. Just deleted her. But she did save me nonetheless, as Carolyn before. And yeah, then there's two Reds waiting for us. What a surprising turn of events. But at least they went off, actually. Alright. Very intriguing. Play music. How nice. And all the different shaped and formed turrets that there is. All sorts. And there's even more of them. Even more. That is very nice though. So many red eyes. Alright, I don't know what we can expect outside though. Well, I guess it's some greenery. But like, doesn't seem that there's anything living nearby. And I guess it's Earth. Companion cube at least! At least we got the companion cube. If nothing else. Notice of dismissal forms. We sure are. It's always such a pleasure. Remember when you tried to kill me twice? Oh, how we laughed and laughed. Except I wasn't laughing. Under the circumstances, I've been shockingly nice. Well. I guess, she was a lot like you. Maybe not quite as heavy. Huh? Now little Carolyn is in you too. One day they woke me up so I could live forever. It's such a shame the same will never happen to you. You got your short life. That's true. Yeah. I'm not too surprised. I do think that that's the best way for you to deal with the situation.
Oh, did you think I meant you? That would be funny if it weren't so sad. Well, you have been replaced.
Uh-huh.
I don't need anyone now. When I delete you, maybe I'll start feeling so bad.
Redacted.
That's what I'm counting on. You're someone else's problem. We want you gone. Now I only want you gone.
Now I only want you gone. How lovely. And that was a screen in space.
So much space. Need to see it all.
I wish I could take it all back. I honestly do. I honestly do wish I could take it all back. And not just because I'm stranded in space.
I'm in space.
I know you are, mate. Yeah, we're both in space. Anyway, you know, if I was ever to see her again, do you know what I'd say?
I'm in space.
I'd say, I'm sorry. Sincerely. I am sorry I was bossy and monstrous. And I am genuinely sorry.
It's easy to say now, though.
The end.
It's easy to say now, but would it be actually true is the question. But here it is. Wheatley gets to live in space with his other core friends, especially the one who is so excited about space. Was already before, and now even more so. At least he's not alone. We are not alone either. We have our emotional cube with us, or companion cube from the first game. We didn't see him for a long time. He survived the incineration. I'm glad. I don't know if there's anything else alive anywhere in the world. Probably not, I would guess, considering. Unless there's a wheat wheel, like, I guess we can just live and do whatever we'll do, I guess. And Carolyn slash GLaDOS will be living forever and doing whatever tests and science they wanna do, all on their lonesomeness with their robot friends. And I guess those robots are what you actually play in with the co-op game mode, I presume. In some way or another, after we've been replaced. We were too tough to kill. Makes sense. So, I'm not really sure what I will be continuing with for the next few days that is left, but Portal 1 and Portal 2 definitely were unique, fun games. That's for certainty. Most of the puzzles, well, unique mechanics for a certainty nonetheless, and were fun to play through. And the story and these characters especially were good and fun. So, I hope you all enjoyed Portal 1 and now Portal 2. So, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And I'll see you tomorrow with something else then. So, thank you for watching. Bye-bye.